Hi, I'm Xingyue. I'm from the US and I graduated from Peking University, majoring in art. The Yellow River and Tongjiang River are both rich in history. Today we're going to take a journey to explore their ancient culture. Let's go! Hi, I'm Xingyue. Right now we're in Shanxi province in Huayin city. Right now we're in Shuangchun village. We came here because there's someone really important who lives here. He's super important in the world of Chinese intangible cultural heritage. His name is Zhang Laoshi. Right here. See? We're gonna try to find him. Huayin老腔is a form of regional opera from the middle reaches of the Yellow River in the Guangdong area. It has a long history. The style of their singing is bold, and it has been described as the earliest rock and roll of the lowest plateau. Zhang Ximin told me, Huayin Laoqiang has been passed down for hundreds of years from generation to generation in the Zhang family of Shuangchun village. Now, with the help of various media channels, Huayin Laoqiang has been performed on various national and even international stages. This ancient art form has increasingly received the recognition it deserves.
你看我74了，我也是希望这个年轻人学老腔。
Yang Junyan, a teacher from Lena Normal University, brings her students to the school as usual. They are young people who volunteered to participate in a campus campaign to learn about intangible cultural heritage. Zhang Ximin is happy to see them. He decides to perform a Huayin Laoqiang shadow puppetry show for the students, an art form that is not seen so often nowadays. Chinese shadow puppetry is the most traditional form of Huayin Laoqiang performance. The dolls, made of cowhide, come to life in the hands of the senior artists. With the vigorous singing and instrumental music, the image of battlefield heroes of yore is restored. That's why Huayin Laoqiang is also known as heroic opera. To see such an exquisite art form in a small mountain village is quite astounding. The young students were fascinated, and we arranged a grand performance for tomorrow.
Hello.
More than 2,000 years ago, during the Han Dynasty, work songs sung by boatmen along the Yellow River shaped the origins of Huayin Laoqiang. The brave, rugged character integrated into the culture is apparent when watching a performance of Huayin Lao Qiang. And these characteristics have been passed down generation by generation, as we saw in the young students. There is an ancient Chinese saying, "A single voice roars out a thousand things." This is one way to describe the charm of the Yellow River and its culture.
The Yellow River is really pretty. It's the first time that I've been so close to it. Thousands of years ago, on the same river where the boats went across, and that's where they had the first time that they ever said Lao Qiang. And today, we can still hear the sounds of Lao Qiang in the same area. This is really amazing. Right now we're in Jiangsu province in the city of Suzhou. Right now we're at Zhengfu. You can see here it says Suxiu Xiaozhen. So we're looking for someone named Yao Zhuo. See? She's really good at Suxiu and she has a lot that she can show us around. So we're gonna go find her. This is all embroidery. It's completely stitched by hand. They did it one stitch at a time. You have to check out the detail on this. It's so, so cool.
Hello.
Hello.
你好。是姚州老师吗？对对，你好你好。你好，我是星月。我们是想看看你们的刺绣。啊，非常欢迎你们。你可以看到我们现在。这个工作坊里面有非常多的绣娘老师们。中国刺绣的历史呢，其实已经有2000多年了。在我们苏州吴县这一带，以前是吴国嘛，那个时候据记载，吴国人就已经将刺绣运用到了我们的服饰上面，从而呢，我们这个刺绣也就变成了家家户户都会从事一个手工劳作。是因为我们品牌馆到了，我姐姐就在里面，我介绍你们认识。
好呀。
双面的刺绣，但是我们可以做到双面的颜色。
同一张，
我们把面料上双面三一绣。
这一件作品要绣一年多的时间。
对，
天哪。
Yao Jianping Suzhou embroidery perfectly combines silk thread, color, composition, and needlework. This traditional skill is also recognized as a form of fine arts and is one of the most distinctive cultural symbols of China.
Xi Zhongshuji, 他在2017年出访，瑞士。到洛桑的时候，他带去的是代表我们中国的一件礼物，是我们苏绣的仕女蹴鞠图。这件作品呢，其实也是代表我们民族的一种文化自信，然后代表我们中国工艺的一种精湛，也是向世界在讲述我们中国的故事。
Yao Zhuo and Yao Lan represent new generation inheritors of Suzhou embroidery.They have incorporated elements of Suzhou embroidery into interior design, clothing, and jewelry for daily life. It is a kind of local fashion that is popular among the Chinese youth.
It really fits the young people's mindset, I think. Yeah. It really makes you think. It's not like, oh, it's really good. It's just...
Young people can also learn how to create their own works for themselves. Tomorrow, I'm going to try on an outfit made with Suzhou embroidery and experience Southern Chinese culture in the classical gardens of Suzhou. Suzhou Embroidery Gardens and folk music. When these three cultural elements come together simultaneously, they bring about the quintessential beauty of Southern Chinese culture. It's like time travel. The combination of tradition and innovation brings about a sense of pride in young people today. The Changjiang River brought about civilization to its surrounding areas, as well as gifts of the earth. One of these gifts being silkworms, who produced the silk that became one of the most prominent sources of income for early inhabitants. The younger generation are creative and innovative, and they have a new globalized perspective, giving it a new sense of life and energy. Right now we're in Shanxi province in a place called Wanongxian. Right now we're here at Miaoqian Tun. It's right at the base of Houtuci. We came here first because there's someone who lives in the village here. His name is Jia Haodong. So let's go find him.
Come.
所以很多人他们说如果想了解后土祠的话就应该找您，是这样的吗？对，我是生在这里，长在这里，工作也在那里。咱这个后土祠啊，它其实是清朝的一个建筑，嗯，九六年定为国宝单位。
所以您觉得它最大的意义是什么？
它源于这个古人对土地的一种崇拜，是生于土，归于尘，嗯，吃的用的都离不开土。 古能生万物，地可发千行。这个后土祠它里边供的就是后土娘娘，就是黄天后土。哎，这个就是后土祠。啊。后土
temple has maintained the original layout of ancient Chinese ritual architecture. The clock tower, the drum tower, and the traditional pin-shaped Chinese theater all make it easy to imagine how lively it must have been back when people came here to celebrate the land.
这个都是用面做的。用面做的？对。你像这个家禽，它都有。嗯。嗯。好像个蛋糕。对。所以这个是只有在丰收的季节才会摆出来的。对对对。嗯。它都是源于土地的。
就是有土地的滋润滋养，才有他们生长的空间。就咱这个后土祠啊，屡建屡毁。清同治1870年搬到这儿，嗯，咱们现在处的这个位置就是清同治年间搬的，这个规模啊，跟北京故宫是可以相提并论啊。当时这个庙号称海内祠庙之冠。
那这个是它以前的样子是吗？
对，以前的样子。
For hundreds and thousands of years, this is where emperors came to celebrate the land. Located at the confluence of the Yellow and Fen rivers, this temple is regarded as the source of the culture of Chinese ancestry. Today's Houtu Temple retains the architectural style of the Qing Dynasty. It's interesting to think about where the imperial palace was back in ancient times.
你看那个大的那个就是黄河，以前这个河床窄，它现在因为经过这很多年以后，黄河这个水大冲刷的，然后把这河道给一直加宽了变宽了。然后我们去三楼看看那个老庙那个遗址，哎，那有个定位，咱们就可以研究看见吗？这个那个方块，哎，反过来的，哎，反过来那个福字，
为什么反过来？
特别之处在这儿了。
嗯，
就是老庙那个地方在哪？就是用这个反着过来这个福字定位，嗯，然后在这个方向向前2公里，就是以前老庙那个地址。
那这一片都是以前那个往那个鱼池，踏寻这个以前这个后土祠这个足迹是挺好的，嗯，啊，让后辈人不要忘到这个祖先，不要忘到这个根嘛。
So when you touch it right here, you can feel the original Hotutsu and how it was in its original state. So it's really cool for us to be here. The infiltration of water and nourishment of the soil together gifted this land with the proliferation of people and a prosperous civilization.The people thus respected the land, which is why the Hotu Temple was rebuilt so many times. Hotu Tsu also celebrates two aspects that are very highly regarded in Chinese culture, simplicity and diligence. Today we took a journey through the splendid history and deep-rooted culture in China, and there will be many more stories to come.
姚建平老师，
啊，三朵花，
三朵花，哇，你写好甜啊！
好，我先来说说。
你知道后土祠吗？嗯，你觉得那里怎么样？
很美。
很美啊。